गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रेन एंड वेलकम बैक फॉर योर इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्नड अ पोएम द लॉन्गेस्ट जर्नी. आई होप यू ऑल रिमेंबर अबाउट द टू ब्रदर्स हु वर फाइटिंग एंड डूइंग देयर वर्क फास्टर बिकॉज हूएवर विल बी द लास्ट दे हैव टू स्विच ऑफ द लाइट एंड दैट पर्सन हैज़ टू कम टूवर्ड्स द बेड in that darkness, and how the boy got frightened on the way and how it was the longest journey for the boy. I hope you all remember. So dear children, as you all know, we have completed only two chapters of grammar. So for the next upcoming days, we will continue with our grammar portion. Today I'll teach you in English grammar the third chapter, simple, complex and compound sentences. We'll learn about simple, complex and compound sentences. What are these simple, complex and compound sentences? They are the structure. They are the structure of the sentence. So the sentence structure is simple, compound, complex. If you remember, earlier I told you about sentence. What are sentences? A group of words which make meaningful sense. Meaningful and complete sense is known as sentences. And in how many parts it had been classified? Sentences can be classified into assertive, assertive or declarative, both are same. Okay, so they are assertive or declarative, second interrogative, third imperative and fourth exclamatory sentences. And they were on the basis of the meaning they convey, isn't it? In which we learnt about declarative, in which we are taking simple sentences, interrogative, in which we are asking questions, imperative, in which we are giving order, command or request, an exclamatory sentence which related to an strong feeling, which is related to a strong feeling or emotion. So today we will continue with the structure of the sentence. Sentences can also be classified into simple, compound and complex sentences on the basis of their structure. On the basis of the structure, sentence can be classified into how many parts? They are three. What are they? Simple sentences, compound sentences and complex sentences. So first we will learn about simple sentence. Simple sentence. Simple sentence contains a subject and a predicate. All the sentences contains a subject and a predicate that we have learned already. So we have learned already that simple sentences, normally a sentence has subject and predicate, but simple sentences has only one subject and one predicate. That is the first point. Second, expresses a complete thought. That what is the meaning of sentence? Which expresses a complete thought. Example, the boys went to the park. So here in this example, the boys went to the park. What is the subject and what is the predicate? So subject means the main part. Boys. Where that boy gone? Went to the park. Okay, so this is known as simple sentence. Let's continue. Tip. A simple sentence is also called an independent clause. Okay, what is simple sentence? It is also called as an independent clause. What are independent clause? The clause which are not dependent on anyone. Okay, the clauses which are not dependent upon anyone, they are independent. That means it should not depend either on the front or from the back. It should not depend on any of the other verb or any of the other part of the sentence. It should be only a part which is independent. And how you will identify whether it is independent or dependent? By reading the sentence. As you read the sentence, you can able to identify, okay, this sentence is perfectly correct and complete. That means it is an independent one. But if you read a sentence and you think that no, this is not a complete sentence, half part is missing, that means that sentence is dependent on the other part or on the other verb. That's why it seems to be a dependent clause. Okay, some more examples. There are two parts of a simple sentence. This I have already taught you in the sentence, if you remember. One part tells who or what the sentence is about. This is called the subject. This I told you while I was explaining you the chapter sentence, if you remember. That one part tells who or what the sentence is about. This is called the subject. The other part tells what is happening. This is called the predicate. Remember, the subject of a sentence is not always at the beginning. Okay, many a times in many questions also we have seen while doing the exercise of sentence chapter that subject every time it won't be the beginning of the sentence. Many a time subject can go at the end of the sentence also. We have to identify while reading the sentence. Okay, next point is your compound sentence. Now, what are compound sentences? A compound sentence has two or more independent clauses. I told you about independent clause and dependent clause. I hope you all understood. So, here it's given. A compound sentence contains two independent clauses or more than that, that are joined together. Like, see here, example is given over here. She works in a city, but she lives in the suburbs. Is it? She works in a city, but she lives in the suburbs. So, what is this but? It is the joining word. And it is a conjunction also. Is it? It is a conjunction. So, when one full sentence joined with conjunction, any of the conjunction word, but if we will remove the conjunction also, the sentence has its own independent clause. It is known as compound sentence. You remember I told you when you people were in class 6th about compound words. When two separate words which have separate meanings combine together and form a different meaning is known as compound words. Like black. Black means kala in Hindi, isn't it? Board. Board means normal board. So both are separate words. Isn't it? But, and both have separate meaning also. But when we join both the words together, black plus board equals to blackboard. So it is making a different meaning. That is what your compound words. In the same way, compound sentences are made. Two sentences which have different meanings, but combined together with any of the conjunction and make a meaning, a complete sentence meaning, it is known as compound sentence. And a compound sentence consists of two or more independent clause. Okay? Example, she works in the city, but she lives in the suburbs. Okay, so here she works in a city. This sentence also we can say in an independent way. It is not dependent on any of the other word or verb or other sentence. Second, she lives in the suburbs. This is also an independent clause. So both the clauses are independent. they don't depend on any of the other part of the sentence or on any of the other verb. So two things we learned till now. First, simple sentence. Second, compound sentence. In simple sentence, we learned that a simple sentence has only one subject and one predicate, and it expresses a single complete thought that has only one finite verb. Okay. In the same way, second one we learned, compound sentences. In this sentence, there are two or more independent clauses that are joined together, and they are joined with coordinating conjunctions or correlative conjunctions. Okay. Sorry. See, one more example I'll show you. Compound sentence, independent clause, independent clause. I drink green tea. Independent. They drink coffee. This is also independent, but they both are joined with a conjunction but. So if we want, we can say this clause also separately, or else if we want, we can say this clause separately, because they are independent clause. Okay. See, it's given over here. This clause could stand alone as a sentence. This clause could stand alone as a sentence. But we are joining it with the conjunction. And what is the conjunction over here? But. I hope you all understood compound sentence. See, again it's given. A compound sentence has at least two independent clauses. Or it can have more than that. But it should be independent. Some more examples. A compound sentence consists of two main or equal importance, two main clauses of equal importance joined together with a conjunction. I like coffee. Let's see, various conjunctions are given. I like coffee and I like tea. Peter was late, but Chris waited for him. I can walk home or I can take a taxi. These all are your independent clause, which are not dependent on any part of the sentence. And if you want, they can stand alone as a sentence. I like coffee. It's a sentence. While saying I love coffee, whether you feel that no, it is dependent? No, not at all. I hope you all understood. So when you people will be solving the questions, you have to keep in your mind some points of simple sentences and especially some points of compound sentences, because compound sentence is the easiest one. You just have to read the sentence, and while reading you can able to understand that, okay, this part of the sentence is not dependent on the other part, and neither the other part is dependent upon this part. Just they are joined with one conjunction. That's why it is a compound sentence. Third one is complex sentences. Now, what are complex sentences? First, we learned about simple sentence has one subject and one predicate. Second, we learned about compound sentence. In the compound sentence, two independent clauses are related with each other with a conjunction. Okay, now third is your complex sentence. A sentence that contains an independent clause and a dependent clause. Okay, so the complex sentence is, what a complex sentence is? A sentence that contains an independent clause and a dependent clause also. In the first one, only subject predicate, one subject, one predicate. In simple sentence, in compound sentence, it has two or more than two independent clauses. No dependent clause, only independent clause. But now in the complex sentence, we are learning that the complex sentence contains independent clause also as well as dependent clause also. This will be easy. If you know the real meaning, if you know the definition, this will be easy for you to understand, to bifurcate the sentences. Okay, so the structure of sentences are of three kinds: simple, complex, compound. Simple I already told you, compound I told you, now I am telling you about the complex one. Let's see, here also I have made some differentiation between independent clause and dependent clause, which will be easy for you to understand.
independent clause contains a subject and a predicate. Okay, fine. Dependent clause also contains a subject and a predicate. So both are same. But in independent clause, it can stand alone as a sentence. If you remember, I told you just now in compound sentence that it can stand alone as a sentence. But dependent clause cannot stand alone as a sentence. Okay, like for example, our dog chewed the furniture. It can stand alone. It is making a sense. It is a complete sentence. So this is independent. But when we talk about dependent, while we were out, does it make a sense? Yes, it makes a sense, but it is not complete. While we read this, while we were out, by reading only we can understand that no, it's not complete. Something is missing, isn't it? So that what shows you the difference between independent and dependent clause. See the full one. Our dog chewed the furniture while we were out. So this one we called as an independent clause, and this one we will be calling as dependent, because this part of the sentence depends upon the first part. Our dog chewed the furniture. It makes an independent clause, so it doesn't need the other part of the sentence. But the second part of the sentence needs the first part. Without this, it will be incomplete. Now understood correctly the meaning of independent and dependent clause? Okay, independent clause can stand alone. Both have subject and predicate. All the sentences are having subject and predicate. Only difference is that in simple, we are having one subject, one predicate. In compound, we are having subject, predicate, both. But both are independent clauses joined with a conjunction word. And in complex, here also we are having subject and predicate, because no sentence is complete without a subject and a predicate. Okay, so here also we are having subject and a predicate, but here we are having one independent clause and one other party will be the dependent clause. Okay, example I told you, by this I think you can able to understand. Dependent clauses are introduced by subordinating conjunctions, and those subordinating conjunctions are after, although, as, when, while, until, because, before, if, since, but, all this comes under your conjunctions. When a complex sentence begins with a dependent clause, a comma separates the two clauses. If the complex sentence is beginning with the independent clause, then no problem. You just have to start it. But if it starts with a dependent clause, which is dependent on the other part of the sentence, then you have to separate it with a comma. See example. These all are subordinating conjunction. When, if. When the cake is brown, remove it from the oven. When the cake is brown. When the cake is brown, you are starting with subordinating conjunction. When the cake is brown, half sentence it is. When the cake is brown, jab cake brown tha. Aage, what will be the next part? Something is missing. So that's why this is dependent clause, which we are bifurcating with a comma. Just now I told you that if the sentence starts with a dependent clause, then we have to separate it with the comma. But if it starts with independent clause, no need to separate it with a comma. Automatically it will get separated by the subordinating conjunction. And the subordinating conjunctions example I told, if, but, and, although, all these are your subordinating conjunction. Okay, so that what is given over here. Second one, you will definitely lose if you don't try. You will definitely lose. It makes a complete clause. It is independent. If you don't try, what if you don't try? That means that something is missing. That comes under your dependent clause. Now, if you want, you can see your book also, because I will be reading the book part for you now. All those things which I told you, what we have learned the sentences. First of all, I told you about types.
that sentence is assertive, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory. Then I told you about the structure. How many parts it has been divided in the structure? Three. What are they? Simple, compound, complex. Is it? Then in simple, we learnt that it has only one subject and one predicate. Is it? And by that, we can able to understand that a simple sentence has only one subject and one predicate, and it makes a complete meaningful sense. Okay, then we learnt about complex sentences, compound sentences we learnt second, and I told you about the compound words also. So in the compound sentences, what is the definition? That two independent clause, two or more independent clause joined together with a conjunction is known as your complex sentences. And compound sentences. And third, we learnt about complex sentence. In the complex sentence, there also we are having subject and predicate, but in this we are having one part of the sentence as independent and other part as dependent. It doesn't matter that it is starting with dependent or independent types of sentences. So let's read the book. Three, simple, complex and compound sentences. Sentences can be classified into assertive. Assertive or declarative are same. Interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentences on the basis of the meaning they convey. Sentences can also be classified into simple, compound and complex sentences on the basis of their structure. Simple sentence, first one. A simple sentence has only one subject and one predicate. It expresses a single complete thought and has only one finite verb. It is having only one finite verb. Some examples. You must work hard to pass the exam. You must work hard to pass the exam. You must work hard to pass the exam. This is, you must work hard is your subject, to pass the exam is your predicate. In the same way, he told me a funny story. Being tired, he went off to sleep. In spite of being rich, he is unhappy. These all are simple sentences. It is having one subject, one predicate, and having a complete thought with one finite verb. Secondly, we learnt about compound sentences. A compound sentence has two or more independent clauses. That's what I told you. Which are joined together by conjunctions. This also I told. In a compound sentence, each clause can make good sense by itself and can therefore stand alone as a complete sentence. Each clause is independent of the other and is called a coordinate clause. Thus, a compound sentence is made up of coordinate clauses. The clauses in a compound sentence are joined by coordinating conjunctions or correlative conjunctions. Some of the examples of the conjunctions are given. Coordinating and correlative. Some of the examples of coordinating conjunctions are and, but, or, so, otherwise, still, yet, for, else, as well as. Okay. Correlative conjunctions, hardly, when, either or, not only but also, both and, neither nor, whether or, though yet, if then. By seeing this, you can easily understand. It is not single, it is in the pair. By seeing it in the pair, you can understand they are correlative conjunction. And by seeing in a single way, you can understand they are coordinative conjunction. Some of the examples. Read these compound sentences. The sun rose, the fog disappeared. Both are having independent clause and they are joined with conjunction and. You must work hard or you will not pass the exam. It is joined with or. You must work hard is also an independent clause. You will not pass the exam is also an independent clause. He is very rich. Independent. He is not happy. Independent. But they are joined with but. She ran fast, independent. She missed the bus, independent. That means they can stand alone. Okay, they can stand alone separately also. They are not dependent on each other. Next, complex sentences. A complex sentence has only one independent clause
called the principal clause or main clause and one or more subordinated clause. A complex sentence contains at least two finite verbs. The subordinate clauses depend on the principal clause for their complete meaning. To introduce subordinated clause and join them to main clauses, we use subordinating conjunctions like while, when, which, where, who, after, before, since, whereas, wherever, as, if, whether, unless, because, so that, than, though, that, and such that. Read these complex sentences. So these complex sentences are, people who work hard become unsuccessful. This is a complex sentence which contains one independent clause and one dependent clause. He is so tired that he cannot stand. This also contains one independent and one dependent clause. He failed because he did not work hard. This also contains one independent and one dependent clause. And all these are your subordinating conjunctions. Although he is poor, he is honest. I told you, if the sentence starts with dependent clause, then we have to separate it with a comma. He is honest, it is an independent clause. Although he is poor, it is a dependent clause. That's why we have separated it with comma. Rest in the other sentence, you can see the first starting is your independent. Starting is your independent. Here also the starting is your independent. That's why subordinating clauses are in between and we have not separated them by comma. The other part is your dependent one. But the fourth one, if you'll see, you can identify, you can find that it is starting with although. Although is your subordinating conjunction. Okay, so when the sentence starts with dependent clause, at that time we have to put comma because he is honest is your independent clause. Okay, so rest is the book exercise. You can see first one will be your homework. Say whether the following are simple, complex or compound sentences. Go through the video nicely, especially the first part, the first pages which I have taken. Go through those definitions, examples nicely. Then you can able to solve this first question. Say whether the following are simple, complex or compound sentences. Okay, rest. I'll explain you first two or first three like that in the next class. And then you people have to do it by yourself. From each questions, if 10 questions are there, then I'll be explaining you 2 or 3. 5-4 questions are there, I'll explain you 1 or 2. But rest other questions, you have to try by yourself. Then only you can able to understand. And if you have any doubt, you all are having my WhatsApp number. So you can text me in my WhatsApp number. Then I'll reply. Okay, so the first question is your homework and this passage, read the passage and answer the question that follow. This is also your homework. Thank you, dear children.